Hello guys, so today we're gonna discuss the concept speed propeller. Concept speed propeller consists of four topics, which is the principles of operation, counterweight propellers, non-counterweight propellers, and the propeller government. Let's start with the principles of operation. So
this is the flow of the presentation.
First, the introduction of topics. Second is the definition of topic, followed by purpose, impacts to innovation. Fifth, explanation, how this work as a group. And lastly, the wrapping up. Now let's start with the principles of operations. Constant speed propeller operate by modifying the angle of the propeller blades, thereby managing the volume of air they engage with. These adjustments mechanism allows the propeller regulate its rotational speed or the RPM in response to changing the flex position, ensuring a consistent RPM despite various in aircraft speed or altitude. By altering the blade pitch, constant speed propeller can optimize engine performance across a range of flight phases, including climbing, cruising, and descending. This ability to adjust the blade angle enable pilots to maintain engine's most efficient RPM, leading to improved fuel efficiency and overall aircraft performance. The main objectives of constant speed propeller is to enhance the efficiency and performance of aircraft engines by enabling pilots to adjust their propeller blade pitch angle. This propeller ensures the engine operates its most RPM for various flight conditions. Understanding the principles of operation, constant speed propeller is important because it allows pilot and aircraft engineers to grasp and fundamental mechanics behind these crucial components. By comprehending how the constant speed propeller function, specifically, how they just adjust blade pitch to maintain a steady RPM despite varying flight conditions. Aviation professionals can effectively utilize and maintain this propeller for optimal performance. This knowledge also enables pilot to make informed decisions regarding propeller settings during different phases of flight, such as takeoff, climbing, cruise, and descent, ultimately leading to improved fuel efficiency, engine longevity, and overall aircraft performance.
So, the next topic that we will be talking about are counterweight propellers. So, this is what a counterweight propeller looks like. It is a design or feature of some propellers that helps the propeller in producing more thrust. Now, as you can see here by the two pictures, there are two different types. There are actually many types of counterweight designs, but its function is really revolving around one idea. So, Monistia. And then this propeller has only two. So, there are two forces acting on a propeller counterweight, that is centrifugal force and the hydraulic piston force. So, centrifugal force is a type of force that pushes an object away from the center of rotation. So, sa itong propeller, ang center of rotation would be its tip or ang iyang cone. This force moves the counterweight mechanism to move the propeller at a high angle. And the hydraulic piston cylinder force is created mechanically through hydraulic pressure. So this is a demonstration on how these two work. So imagine a ball tied to a string, and then the string is tied in a car. Let us see how the ball will react when the car is accelerating. So if atong imagine ang katong ball kay madala, if the car will move forward, the ball will tend to stay behind. So that is an example of centrifugal force. Just like the ball, The counterweight will tend to pull or move the propeller to a higher pitch angle. And so sige, what does it do? An example ganiya, it is defined nga centrifugal force will move the counterweight and will let the propeller move at a higher pitch angle. Kay ganan man mo move ang kay ganan mo sunod ang propeller counterweight sa yang angle of rotation. And then second picture at the bottom shows how the mechanism works, or the mechanical the mechanical thing works. Muni siya ang yung function kay move sa propeller at a lower pitch angle. So if high ang pitch sa propeller, kay mas makaproduce og more thrust, which will help in saving fuel. Next topic is non-counterweight.
Okay, the next topic is non-counterweight propeller. Non-counterweight propeller is a in aircraft design serves to balance control surface, control propeller pitch, and balance crankshaft with oil pressure used to counter their force and return propeller blades to find pitch, and they aid in moving blades to the feather position in feathering designs. The second part of non-counterweight propeller are crucial for balancing control surfaces to prevent control rudder, requiring pilots to check their structural security before flight. Mechanics must also recheck balance after painting a task excluded from an aircraft. Operators preventative maintenance items. This balance is maintained by adding weight inside or on the leading edge of tabs, aileroids, or balance panels. The definition of the non-counterweight is primarily serve three functions in an aircraft design: balancing control surfaces, controlling propeller pitch, and balancing crankshaft and piston engines. The purpose of it is the non-counterweights are used to balance control surface around the axis of the hinge, preventing potentially dangerous control flutter. This balance is really crucial. Pilots often check for non-counterweight structural security in pre-flight. When possible, mechanical must recheck control surface balance. After painting painting control surfaces is not on the list of preventing maintenance tasks that an airplane operator can do without any mechanical line sets. The last part is non-propellers with a counterweight mounted to the blade clamps use centrifugal forces generated by the non-counterweight, which to increase the pitch of the blades. The centrifugal forces generated by the propeller spin cause the counterweight to move into the plane of rotation, raising the pitch of the blades. Feathering is achieved by releasing the governor oil pressure, which causes the non-counterweight and feathering spring of feather the blades. This accomplished by bringing the governor pitch control back to the end of its range. This opens up a port in the governor, enabling the propeller oil to drain back into the engine. The time necessary to feather depends upon the size of the oil passage from the propeller to the engine and force.
Okay, next.
The next topic is this is the non-counterweight propeller, a fixed propeller. Next is
Propeller governor. Basic definition: an aircraft propeller governor is an oil pump with variable speed and control that modifies the angle of the propeller blades. The engine RPM changes in response to changes in the propeller blade angle because the air resistance that the blades encounter. Their purpose: a propeller governor is a mechanism that is response to changing flight condition,
automatically modifies the angle of the aircraft propeller blade in order to maintain constant speed in constant speed. The propeller's blade angle, range is the sole restriction of the propeller governor's adjustment range. Impact or effects on a plane. The governor increases or decreases oil pressure against your propellers, adjust their pitch and response to changes in flight condition and pilot inputs in real time. The purpose of propeller governor is to automatically control and regulate the speed of an aircraft's propeller. It ensures that the propeller maintains a constant speed, which is crucial of optimizing engine performance, fuel efficiency, and overall aircraft operation. The effect of propeller governor in the airplane is maintaining a constant engine speed by adjusting the pitch, of the propeller blades. This ensures optimal engine performance, fuel efficiency, and overall stability during flight.
So that's the four major parts of the constant speed propeller. Let us know the importance of this for us to be able to know what's its uses for aircraft and in the aviation industry. Thank you.